the incisions and how you deal with that is totally different from what we have learned. If you want to increase height, the incision position is crucial. We don't do any more verticals, or we reduce them a lot and technically sensitive. Obviously, this doesn't, nothing in dentistry is easy or sounds like easy, but you can go over simple way, taking connective tissue from areas that are not painful anymore, and really provide the volume that you needed where you need it. And then it's a matter of pushing it away. And this is not easy either, having, as Haram said, a final zirconia abutment that really fits your scenario and you don't have to touch it anymore. Those zirconia abutments, they cost a fortune, you know. So it's true that going from there to there is a matter of controlling the technician to a certain way that you could come up with such a for such a result. You need to know where the margin should be just on a handy position that you could excel on your final restoration. So all of this is easy. If you graft from tuberosity between 3 to 5 millimeters on thickness, you have hypertrophic reactions, and this is patient dependent. Some have more, other people has less. No bone whatsoever was done here, only soft tissue provided by the patient. Today with CBCTs, you can really anticipate if that patient has soft tissue or not. So it's a simple situation. This is a more difficult one, a lousy healing after my socket preservation. As it was mentioned before, maybe one of the most difficult procedures we do. And here I grafted with palette. You can see what we did. And now the red, the yellow line, what it means is what is my bone and what is the defect and what do I need to do? Do I have the bone? Yes. Now what I have in there in order to overcome the problem is a soft tissue problem. So this is the surgery. If I never do a bone graft, I never expose the bone. So rule number one, we always leave periosteum attached to the connective, to the bone. Being minimally invasive means, you know, respect the bone. If you open the bone and you don't do bone graft, it's stupid. You know, you want to create as much blood supply, you want to create a situation where you are you have all the best to survive with your connective tissue. I don't do as much buccal connective tissues as I used to, even though I have a defect, because when I push it to the crown later on, it will be filled. So there are many things that that changes when you start doing this type of techniques, and you see the evolution by yourself about doing it. And we always suture into layers. First, the connective tissue, basically the essence of all surgery is to have everything that you have, you graft has to be really stable. So we suture in two layers, first the graft to the flaps, and then the flap on top of it. The beauty of having such a narrow healing abutment is that you can close anything. It's a matter of, you know, controlling your soft tissue management, delaminate, release your flaps, and then close it in a nicer way. And maybe the issue in implant dentistry, especially in anesthetic areas, is do it once, one stage surgery. Do as less surgeries as possible. Try to have an objective that is clean in your head, and just try to accomplish it if you can. So let's go forward, and this is 3 months later. We have the soft tissue coronal to the adjacent tooth, which is good. This is what we like. So then we can push all that massive soft tissue. Implants are like ridges. When I have a ridge, a pontic, you know, I want to have a really good palatal base in order to increase and excel on my buccal aesthetics.